The performance ended over an hour ago and the party is now in full swing. The show lasts more than 3 hours. It is in many ways more of an opera than a musical. But that's not to say it's an operatic, complex music. Indeed, the music is very simple and full of instantly likeable tunes. The audience loved it. We have been following Les Misérables from the first tentative steps of the early rehearsals.
Somewhat different, because that enormous gate...
It's not surprising expectations are high. The same team of talents that made Nicholas Nickleby a world winner for the Royal Shakespeare Company now turn their combined skills to tackling what's already been a success in Paris, the musical version of Victor Hugo's greatest classic.
I'm doing everything all wrong. Oh God, for shame, I do not even know your name. Dear mademoiselle, I am lost in your spell.
Those works have a great deal of social conscience and a proliferation of characters. There are more differences than there are similarities in the two works. The relationship of plot to meaning is greater in Hugo's writing than it is in Dickens.
Les Misérables of the title are those like the child Cosette, who, despite the promised changes of the French Revolution, are still, years later, suffering poverty and injustice. Jean Valjean, the ex-chain gang prisoner, struggling to enjoy the freedom he deserves, pursued by Javert, the obsessed police officer. Through a plot of political intrigue and insurrection, of heroic sacrifices, escapes, and final reconciliations, there unfolds a panoramic view of France in the first half of the 19th century.
The book has been translated into English on many occasions. The title has always been Les Misérables. Now, if we had decided that we should call our musical The Wretched or The Outcast, people would not have immediately seen that it was a version of one of the great classics of Western literature. I mean, it is a formidable and epic work, and that title, though many people find it difficult to pronounce, an awful lot of people have heard of it and have a slight conscience about the fact that they haven't read it or they started it once and didn't get all the way through it. But actually, far more English people do know the story of Les Misérables than they think they do. That is to say, it's the basis of a great deal of Hollywood production. It's a great deal of television production is based on that wonderful tale of Les Misérables, a man who is fundamentally innocent, who is pursued for the whole of his life by the forces of the law.
We have had to considerably clarify the story for an English audience, because we must assume, not simplify, no, quite in some sense it's quite the opposite. The French audiences would know exactly what was happening all the time, because it's a folk myth in France, Les Misérables. In England, we have to make almost more complex the emotional attitudes of the people so that an English audience will understand what's going on.
The member of the team least in the public eye is the designer, John Napier. Heaped with awards for his set for Cats, for Starlight Express, and for Nicholas Nickleby, it's once again his job to conjure the whole texture and atmosphere of a literary masterpiece.
If you take a book like Les Misérables or Nicholas Nickleby, with its huge range of characters and of situations, you know, just because you've worked in the theatre for a number of years and you've worked with that particular director or other directors, that you are one of the people that are going to have to steer them towards a route through that and provide them with something that is... that has a quality of being real while not being naturalistic. If you take an imaginative leap, they will get there. If you then provide them sometimes with the real artifacts of a room, it looks completely phony. And I don't believe it. I mean, at the end of the day, all I want to do is believe what I'm seeing.
But on the night, it'll be the cast, the characters, their humanity, their loves and sacrifices that carry the dramatic impact of the piece. Cosette, now grown up and to be married, may represent the struggle of the poor and the suffering, but it's the ballad of her love and its triumph that should move an audience's heart.
Absolutely marvellous theatre, just wonderful theatre.
One of the best we've ever seen.
I agree, I think it's fantastic.
Complete breakthrough in the theatre because it's just a musical and opera together with so much message in it, and I think it's just absolutely fantastic.
You're magnifique.
And you're French.
Ah, je suis française et fière de l'être ce soir.
Well, here at the party, the cast are being mobbed, but I managed to get a few of them over to talk to me here. Alan Armstrong, were you surprised by the warmth of that reception, a standing ovation?
Yes, I was really, considering that the bulk of the story is about the social problems of 19th century Paris, 19th century France, and we have this great glitterati audience who nevertheless wept. I think Norman Tebbit should come and see this, and you see, he will find out why people build barricades.
Con, you had one of the very biggest part to play, sustained it for something like 3 hours. Well, what is that like?
Well, it's pretty heavy going, all right, but I find that the part is so exciting to do and the music is so good, and it goes very quickly because you're working so hard, really, and everybody, this is a company effort, I want to say. It's not just people doing different parts, it's a company effort. Everybody works really hard at this show.
The concentration must have been huge. Are you tired now?
I am. I'm absolutely knackered. I am tired now, yes, but it was worth it. It was a fantastic night tonight. Brilliant.
Mary, can I ask you what you were many times what you thought of the show? Can you tell me?
I loved it. I loved it. I think it's probably one of the best things I've seen for a long time musically, because we seem to be short of very good musicals in this country, at least new ones. There seem to be lots of revivals, and this was something totally different. Because
it was almost like an opera, wasn't it?
Yes, and I'm not normally an operatic fan, I must admit, but I loved it because actually the performances were all so good, the music was excellent, the staging was out of this world. And I mean, I think everybody was sitting there with goose pimples, and when everybody stood up at the end and applauded, it was definitely a completely spontaneous reaction to something which I think is destined for a very good run. I hope so anyway, because I think it deserves it.
Thank you very much. Now let me talk to the three people who came into our... We came to your rehearsals very early on.
Yeah, very early on.
Are you pleased with the reception you've had, Francis?
I think so. I mean, I'm still nervous, actually, but it's... It was nice tonight, wasn't it?
Yeah,
it was better.
Phenomenal.
What do you think is the quality of the piece? It's different from anything I've ever seen. It's not quite a pure musical, is it? It's operatic.
It's quite an epic. Well, it's all sung. I mean, there is no book, there is no dialogue. And as opposed to a lot of musicals that have been around lately, it's got a book.
And
quite
you,
a book, in fact.
Now, you sang at Glyndebourne. This is a different audience.
Yes, I was in the Glyndebourne chorus this summer. I have done my musicals, but I've been doing opera for the past 3 years.
What do you think of the merits of the piece?
I think the beauty of it is that it's so unique. I don't think there is anything that you can compare it with. And it's great to have an opportunity to put on something that is so very different. And you know, the team that we've got up around us is phenomenal. And we're all very proud to be part of it. But it is, I think, a very unique thing. Very unique.
Now, it's had a lot of publicity, a lot of build-up. Expectations in the wake of Nicholas Nickleby are high. Do you think you've got an equally big hit?
I hope so. I mean, it's too early for us to say, but I certainly hope so.
We love it. I mean, I play the French version in my car very often, yeah. And that's all in French. I can't understand a word.
To all of you, thank you very much.
Thank you very much.